Ozzy with the Cali Agents. We're right here at the Goons Art Collective in Orange County. Gonna say what's up here to Charlie Medina and E-Real Tattoo. Gonna chop it up and see what they're all about. Come take a look. See you soon.
It's kind of been watered down a little bit since I want to say about a good 10 years or so, because when I started tattooing, it was more sacred, if you will. Like, it was, you kind of picked and choose who you wanted to teach to tattoo or even talk about tattooing, period, you know. And nowadays, TV, and especially TV with all these Ink Master shows and all that, making it very, you know, YouTube go-to real quick, how to put your machine together. I mean, I understand that there's other artists out there that don't have that mentality, where like, oh, I was taught by such and such, and I'm just gonna do it this way, and I don't care what anybody says, which is fine. But I mean, if you have that type of mentality, you start watering it down to where it doesn't have any value when you wanna, like, the sacredness, when you wanna teach it to someone. It's just I might as well just go to YouTube. Some people rather just go to YouTube real quick instead of waiting their time to get actually taught by someone that actually knows their, you know, the deal. So from then till now, it's lost a lot of that value, you know. It's turned into a lot of tattoos have turned into like an accessory thing. You know, you have people coming into tattoo shops asking for prices instead of asking, I want the baddest dude here to tattoo me, you know what I mean? And now they're just coming in, we're like, who's the cheapest here? What's that? So then when you start looking at that, it starts looking at it as like, now there's like shopping for a pair of pants or, you know, a pair of glasses or something. So that's what tattooing is now. It's gotten to where it's an accessory. Some people are going out that Friday night, they want to get their tattoo before they go out that night. Oh, take the day off, you're about to get tattooed, and then this is it, you know. But I mean, It obviously depends on the tattoo and whatnot, you know, but it gets to that point where you start picking and choosing who you want to tattoo, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And
it's really simple. I mean, we usually put the directions on there, you know, as far as you know, emails, DMs. I mean, we're constantly on social media. You know, now it's a good platform to be using versus, you know, so many years ago. So it's really good because especially if we have assistants, they're always on top of it. But the obvious questions is when we say, you know, email here, direct message here, this and that, those are pretty much ways to go about it. But some people sometimes tend to, I think they just get a little excited, yeah, and they just don't tend to like read the, hey, message here. So they wind up commenting on there or something, you know, and they kind of fast forward and then they get to where, hey bro, how much do you charge for this? How much about, my thing is, as professionals, we don't like to charge, we don't like to talk about pricing over, we'll negotiate, you know what I mean? I mean, we like to put prices out there just to say, hey, you know, like advertise. But then when we're actually talking in private, we're negotiating, we're thinking, hey, you know, figuring out what's best we could do so we could get this tattoo on yourself, you know? But you're putting yourself and myself out there saying, hey, Charlie, I want to get this, hey, that. Sometimes we pay no attention to those because we go, no, dude, if you really want a tattoo, figure it out, hit me up, do email, DM, whatever, and then we'll go from there, you know what I mean? And then obviously deposits always make a difference. You know, there's people that do this left and right, you know, with anything. But I mean, as soon as deposits come in, it's locks and dates, it saves time, you know, it reserves a date for us, you know? Yeah. And then that should actually let us know that, you know, hey, this date's for this person, and we're starting doing our research as far as artwork goes, you know? As far as tipping, I mean, it really, honestly, we set a certain price for people, but the way I see it is anything above that is all love. So really, there's no standard, you know, if you guys want to go off of the whole percentage and like you guys do in restaurants and whatnot. I mean, to me, the way I see it is like, if I tell you a certain number and you give me more than that number, I'm always going to remember that. And then like anybody else would, and I'm always going, oh, hey, this guy shows some love.
Next time they come back.
And then and it goes vice versa. Sometimes it's like, hey, you know what? Like I got a couple extra hours on myself. Let's do this, or, you know, and it goes around. But I mean, you have people that are asking for change of, you know, they want to tip you $20, but they're asking if you could break it to give you a 10. You're like, oh, dude, just keep it. I mean, you know what I mean? In the end, it's just going to be like, it's, you know, you don't want to tell them you need it more than I do. But in the end, you're just like, no, dude, it's all good. I got paid what I wanted to get paid, and we're fine, you know. So.
Cool. Yeah. And you know, again, I see a lot of you guys, you know, answering questions and calling people out, but it's not like you're calling people out, so to speak.
Yeah.
And people might kind of seem as you guys fucking egos are high out.
Oh, I understand. Yeah.
Things like that. People might think you're assholes, you know, so to speak. What do you think? What is your perception of people, how you want them to see you as they come approaching to see shit like that?
Yeah, the thing is, it's just you can't really control, like, you know, what happens out there, you know? I mean, everybody has their own way of running their business, you know? Right. Everybody's kind of like a private contractor, if you will. But the thing is, I mean, you do get different types of, I guess, approaches out there, attitudes and whatnot, you know? And it's just how you approach them individually, right, you know? I just try to take care of as each person I try to have a personal relationship with, you know what I mean? That way I understand exactly what they're wanting and what, yeah, and then figuring that out. But I mean, it's all about energy too, you know? You come up with a good energy and then I'll match it, you know?
And you being a true artist as well, I mean, when I got my piece from you, mm-hmm, I let you do your thing, mm-hmm, you know? Mm-hmm. Is that what you prefer? Just letting you be an artist and express your true art form and letting the customer say, hey, I want it done this way, this way, or can you change this, or can you do it this way?
Well,
you get a lot of people that do that, right?
Yeah, well, usually that's the artist's dream is for the person to just say, hey, do you, and do whatever you kind of want.
Yeah.
And I have done that throughout the years, but then later on I kind of try to put myself into their shoes. I go, you know what, maybe ask them, because it challenges you to say, hey, give me some ideas, because I could do skulls and girls all day on his arm.
Yeah.
What if somehow they go, hey, I was thinking maybe religious, and maybe I'd be like, hey, you know what, I haven't done anything religious, I'm gonna challenge myself, and this is how I'd go about it. So I actually ask for the ideas, you know, but I usually like to take over as far as if you're coming to me, obviously, going around fishing to say, hey, Charlie, I want specifically done for you, then obviously let me take over after I've explained what I'm gonna do, you know? Because you do have other people that are there like, well, no, I kinda wanna like this, but I wanna like that, but I wanna face it. I mean, in the end, you wind up telling them, I mean, you wanna tattoo this yourself, you can, because it seems like this, you know more than I, you know? So sometimes you don't wanna come off rude or whatever, but you just gotta let certain people exactly know, like, hey, you know what? For me, like I said, I mean, I do like doing my own thing, my freehand, you know? Most of the time I do like to take over, but I still will always take their input, say, hey, what do you think about this? I mean, we go to the mirror several times before we make it permanent. That way they're like, oh yeah, hell yeah, like, this is exactly what I want, or I'm not feeling this. Okay, and for me, it's like, hey, all right, cool, scratch it then. You know, it's just a marker, and we'll figure it out another time. You know, it's just, you know, it's just to get them at least tattooed that day and then start something.
Cool. Yeah.
I've been working on my brand for a few years now, about I want to say since 2012. And when I'm not tattooing, I mean, I'm constantly either trying to build that or just stay focused on certain projects on there. The only thing is, I mean, they do take focus as far as sitting in front of a computer for hours, you know, that's really what it is, you know. So when I do find that time of chance to do that, then I'll you know, I sit down and I focus on my orders and whatnot. And then I do side projects, you know, I do a lot of like logos and things like that, like silent projects that I do, you know, that sometimes it does keep me sharp on a lot of other things besides, you know, doing my whole brand thing and tattooing, you know. But most of the time, yeah, it's always art related. I mean, something with art, you know. If I'm not tattooing, I'm digitally painting, you know. Yeah. I mean, I'm thinking if it wasn't for it, I mean, you know, it's easy for someone else to show some love, you know, especially if they have quite a following, and if they, anybody else who sees that and sees that you're pretty much of value to their newsfeed, if you will, then that helps me out, you know. I just try to make sure that the content is 100% what it needs to be. Sometimes, since it is my personal one, I tend to go off the loop sometimes. Post other stuff that's not even related to whatever I do, you know, and everybody does that. That's what someone, everybody does that, you know. All of a sudden it's like, oh damn, what the hell's happening here, you know? And you get it, you know. Yeah, no, and before I was like, oh, I shouldn't do that. But then I just figured like, no, it's just, this is what it is, it's me, you know. But I have a certain standard to it where I go, okay, give it a certain many hours. Yeah. Whoever caught it, and then take it down because it's back to focus on whatever it is, you know.
Yeah.
So I try to keep it, like I said, as professional as possible. No, what inspires me, honestly, is back to social media, is now when sometimes it might look like someone's not doing anything, and then you're just scrolling through your phone, you know, you're just like, look at this guy, he's just lazy there. A lot of times, it's social media works as far as, like, if you're following the right people, you're following inspiration left and right, and you're just like, damn, look at this guy, that guy's killing it. It's 8 in the morning, and this guy's setting up for this tattoo, and you're sleeping in the bed, so I'm gonna get up, because homeboy's tattooing, whoever it is, you know, and then all of a sudden, this guy's painting, that guy's doing whatever, and then if you're an artist that's on your game, and then you see that, even if you're just sitting for a little bit, those little things get you like, hey, you gotta start rolling the ball. So, not to mention too, but what I do is I follow enough inspiration on there to where I get inspired by a lot of, like, I do follow a lot of models, you know, and they take a lot of really good pictures with high resolution cameras. So when you're scrolling by and all of a sudden you get stopped on your tracks by certain images, I mean, screenshot left and right, because I use those for, you know, inspiration. And then plus, like I said, the people I follow. So not just that, but I mean, even then, just my own, if I'm away from social media, then it's just like, kind of like, I figure like, what are you lacking, or what do I got pending? Because I do, I mean, you look at my laptop and my iPad, I got so much projects pending, so it's one of those where I finally get to sit down and then continue on that, you know? It's kind of difficult to answer really, just because I mean, I do have some girls that actually are models, and they'll hit me up and ask me if I can paint them, and even then I'll turn them down because it just depends on that picture. I have to be like, oh wow, this is amazing. Sometimes they go out of their way and then send me pictures, and then I'm just nope. And if I feel bad because some of these girls are like, self-esteem. Yeah. It's like all of a sudden they're like, oh my God, I'm not pretty enough. This, that. But no, you're gorgeous. It's just, this is not the right picture I'm looking for. Sometimes I tell them, hey, you know what? This is more or less what I'm looking for. And then I'll screenshot whatever I've had and send it to them. But then again, these are people that are paying a little bit more money for a camera guy to come in and take pictures and the lighting and all that. I'm like, you're doing this with your iPhone 8 or something. I mean, it's not working so much, you know what I mean? Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. But I mean, I'm not gonna sit there going back and forth with them, you know? And the thing is, I like to go and choose the girl and then out of me. But if the girl's coming to me, then most of the time, then it's business. Then I just figure, okay, well, I mean, it's a commission, you know? Yeah. And even then, I try not to do commissions because it's a, no, do it this way, do it that way, because that's how I want it. Yeah. And then, so it, to me, it takes away from
your creativity.
Yeah, it's not what I want anymore, you know? So I try to stay away from that, you know, okay, as much as possible. Located in the city of Orange, tattooing at Goons Art Collective here in the city of Orange. just get a hold of me through either, I mean, you know, Instagram or email or.
What's your Instagram?
Oh yeah, Instagram would be Charlie Period Medina. At Charlie Period Medina. Sorry.
Cool, man.
Cool.
Yeah.
Thanks, Charlie. Really appreciate that, man.
Cool. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. Thank you.
Awesome.
All right.
You know, because I started in Texas over in like the projects and shit, and then I moved out here after I was like 20 or something, and then I started tattooing out here.
Cool.
Actually down the street from here.
Right on. And what kind of style are
Black and gray, lettering. I used to be really known for like traditional work and shit, but I got tired of that, so I'm not doing that no more.
Cool.
And some other bullshit, whatever, you know?
Yeah.
I do whatever. You pick it, I stick it, if I feel like doing it.
Yeah. What's the story behind the whole Goons Art Collective?
Goons, actually, I started it as a clothing brand probably a year and a half ago with three of my buddies. They weren't putting in any work, so they got dropped. And then me and my buddy Lino started picking it up. Tried doing it again, and we're actually gonna be producing some more clothes. But then I wanted to open a shop because I got tired of working for everyone, and I got tired of a lot of people's shit.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'm just gonna do me, you know? And then me and Charlie were working at a different shop before, but you know, things weren't working out for us, so we made something work for us, you know? So we started, and I couldn't think of a name. I was like, fuck it, go and join it, you know?
Yeah.
So already got the LLC, why not? I just try to focus more on myself. I know a lot of artists are like really worried about what everyone else is doing and you know who's fake, who's real, and like you know, I'm just trying to stay in my own bubble, my own lane, and not focus on everyone and what they're doing, and just try to do my thing to the best I can do it, right, and not really focus on anyone else.
Because the way I see it with any other industry, there's no right or wrong way to do it.
That's what I feel.
Telling you, hey, you should do it this way, you should do it that.
Yeah.
You do it your way, it's your way, and you're creating something different, and people trip out on that, that's like, fuck, it is.
Yeah, there's a lot of haters. I mean, in Southern California, there's a lot of politics about like the industry, but also when you travel to different states or countries, they have their own politics. So there's no right or wrong way of being a part of the industry and going certain ways, because everyone has their own, you know, everyone was raised different, right. You know? Just because your parents raised you some way doesn't mean it's wrong compared to another parent that raised someone else a different way, you know? It's about being open-minded and just doing what's best for you and your own career, you know?
Like,
if you're focused on trying to follow a thing, like, no one became great following the rules.
Right, yeah, exactly.
Like, and, you know, everyone became great.
Huh? Outlaw shit.
Outlaw shit. Donald, baby.
And,
take on the industry. I try to stay a part of it. Like, I try to be an artist, like, not a part of, I don't know how to explain it. Like, I'm an artist industry, but I'm not an industry artist, you know?
Right.
I don't try to put myself with the group. I don't care who's wearing what clothing. I don't want to wear a stolen badge. If I'm getting stolen, Jeremy calls them cool, but just for like an example, they're a big brand that everyone kind of wants to be a part of. Like, I don't care if I have that Tatsoul fucking sponsorship or the Kingpin or, you know, Lottie Dottie, you know, whoever likes to party. I don't care about any of the brands. Like, I just want to do my own thing and stick to myself. So, and if she, they just do their own thing, I do mine. I don't care about tips. Cause I'm pretty cool. I do a set price for an appointment. So any day I work, I do one appointment a day, and it's just a set price. Whether we work that full day or not, could I do 2 to 10? Is the cutoff time? I'm not saying max out fucking whatever you want till 2 to 10, you know? Cause I'm getting older and I can't really work that way anymore, you know? But this, an appointment with me, I run in for a certain amount of price. We do what we can in that day. And that's cool with me. I stay happy with that price. I don't need to get rich off this. I don't need to, you know, feel cool because I'm making so much. I just want to do a cool piece and continue my day. But just contact me on my, I have an appointment page or my number. And contact me like you would any other business. You know, you call, contact like a car dealership. Don't hit them up. Hey, car, how much? Like, you know, like, what the fuck?
Gas brakes.
Well, yeah, gas brakes, you know, yeah. Monies, you know, like, I'll return the same amount of energy that people give to me.
Right.
So if you come at me stupid, I have a lot of time on my hands and I think I'm hilarious, so I'm gonna fuck around with you, you know?
Yeah, we, like I said, that was one of the examples. We like bust up and seeing your fucking, you call these dudes out and shit, but it's like, you know, we see it funny.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We see it like a fucking.
I see it funny too, so, you know?
Outsiders may think, including Dan, they're like,
oh,
what an asshole.
Yeah, I got a lot of people like, oh, you think you're the shit? It's like, no, dude, I'm just really bored and, you know, running sober, so. I have nothing better to do than be like, eh, fuck it, let's see where this goes. And I actually booked a lot of those people still.
Yeah, they
come. Like, some of them I'll even ask, like, hey, can I post this? This is funny. They're like, yeah, go for it.
Yeah, that's cool.
I'll block out your face and all that, you know? I mean, like any other business, you know, you contact the business, come to them correct, you know? Like, review my stuff, see what I have to offer. If you show the sign that you have no idea the kind of work, like, if you hit me up for some, I don't know, Thailand tribal, I'll be like, you obviously haven't even seen my work, because like, I don't do that, so I don't know why, you know?
Ooh.
Don't hit me up because you want a tattoo, hit me up because you like my work, and I'll be like, cool, let's do my work on you as a collector, you know?
Yeah.
So that's cool with me. I'm actually working on a couple different businesses as we speak. Right now, the clothes is a part of the Goons, so I count that as one collective. I'm working on opening a barbershop right now. I actually was just talking to someone yesterday about going in about opening a bar. So I might be doing that within the next year, a year and a half. And then I have a couple other projects that are kind of in the making, and I'm talking to different people that, you know, I could get it going. And I can't really say much right now because I don't want to be like, this is what's going down, I'm doing it. And then none of it happens, and I'm like, look at this fucking asshole, you know? Like, he thinks he's doing something, but, you know, he didn't do shit, you know? Like, I was like, oh, fuck, shouldn't have said it, you know? But a couple things are in action, and some of them are in review. scene, because that's really one. I'm at the age right now where I just want to invest into getting something settled for the future, you know?
Right, for sure.
This can only last so long. I guess so many dates. Social media is cool. I mean, in the industry now, it used to be a lot of word of mouth, but now it's like part of being a tattooer is not only having good art. You could be have good art and not be known. And even though it's not about popularity, it is about marketing, advertising, and like really seeing a whole other perspective of a business level into applying it to your art and showcasing it and getting it out there for people to see. So now you could bring it in, and then you have to like review the way you do it. Even social media, you have to like, I don't know if it's called monetizing or something. It's the way that you set up your own pages and the way that you display your work so people could see what you have to offer in the way that you want to see it offered. So when they hit you up, like people see on my work, they automatically know the kind of work I do, what I do. Because I make it so like, you know?
Yeah.
Like it's all about how you work it, and it's really beneficial if you use it right. If you're using it to fuck off, you know, you're gonna be a fuck off. But if you're using it to a way to like build your business or your brand, even if you and your business is a brand itself, then you know, as much work as you put in that, as much work you're gonna get in return, you know?
Yeah.
So honestly, social media is one of the best things you could do right now. You could be the wackest artist. I don't want to say any names, because, you know, there's a bunch. You know? Yeah. But you can have a huge, like, social media, like, thing and just be one of the wackest artists, and people are going to suck your dick because you have 100,000 followers, you know? And they automatically think you're good because you have a million followers, and you still suck dick at tattooing, you know? Like,
sure.
But, I mean, it's not the right way to do it, but, you know,
it's in making it.
Yeah. You know, it's a powerful instrument that you can use in the correct way to showcase what you have. And even if, maybe I think these guys are whack, and there's people that like it. Everyone's opinion and taste is different, you know? So, what you do, there's gonna be someone out there that's gonna like it. So it's up to you to apply the skills to showcase it as many people to get the small collector group that like it, like Hot Topic.
Yeah.
You know, I don't like Paramore, but they have a whole shop full of Paramore kind of people. You know, like, you know? So there's a group for everyone, you know?
Yeah,
so
sure.
It's just about finding a group and
cool, man.
Getting it there, you know?
And,
Instagram at @lrills_tattoos, and that's my portfolio. I use it as a public portfolio, and pretty much only like that. Maybe once in a while you see me post like some bullshit because I'm bored, but 90% of the time it's a business, 100%. And then from there, I have on there my contacts to get at me through like booking an appointment, which is an appointment page that I also use to showcase one, not only how I work, it has different ways of how I work, how to send a deposit, and really do the whole nine of how to work with me. So you could review it with even without even hitting me up for any questions. Most of them already answered. So
cool. I got one. People who are building their brands right now, you know what I mean? What, you got any advice for them when you're trying to build and trying to move forward? And you know, there's a lot of people out there that when you're first starting out, that just immediately like want to knock you down. Do you have any advice to those people who are trying to build? Like any tips how they should do it, go about it?
Yeah, definitely. When you're trying to build a brand, everyone's gonna hate. Everyone's gonna fucking hate because half the people are scared to do it themselves. And you even get people that are judgmental and like, oh, this guy thinks he's a shit because he's trying to do this, he's pushing this. Who do you think he is, you know? It's not about that. You want to do something, so you put in all your efforts to do it. So don't be afraid to fucking push as much as you can. And honestly, invest whatever you can to build your brand. Whether it's paying someone to do fucking dope logo, you know, paying someone to do your shirt, try it. Sometimes you can't always go to your friends. because they push you to the side because you're a friend. Kick away, kick away, kick away. Skip that shit, go to someone that's down to do it. Even if you pay more, it's about the work. So don't be shy, you know, closed mouths don't get fed. If you're not pushing your brand and you're not your biggest fucking fan, you know, if you can't take pride in yourself, no one else is gonna take pride in you or your fucking brand. So push hard, bang that shit, and you know, don't take in consideration any kind of hate. Because as long as you're trying to build, you know, it's about growth. Continue growing and continue being a person with growth. And you can't stop growing because people don't want you to. It doesn't make sense, you know?
Feel that.
All right.
Cool, man. Thank you, Ralph.
That's it, man.
All right. Yeah. Well, appreciate
that.
Stay lit.
There you go.